This is Keepsakes, the podcast. I'm Jay Agonoy. It's the 29th episode of the podcast. First and foremost, thank you very much for listening wherever, whenever you're listening. Either you're listening on Spotify, Google Podcasts, or Apple Podcasts. I actually wasn't supposed to have any content for this episode, but I thought of bringing back my past recordings starting from 2011. The reason for this is because I'm actually plotting every event that I've attended that are related to otaku stuff, anime stuff, cosplay stuff. And one of the golden nuggets in that time, especially in 2011, is the launch of what is the first maid cafe outside of events. So this is a standalone cosplay maid cafe, and it's called Meidolls Cafe. And I was able to talk with the head, the owner, and I believe there's a companion kasama niya. And during that recording, they were just at a small space at the back of the Saunterfield Building in Cainta. And months, years passed by, they went and moved to a visible location, visible within the street. So, yeah, that's Meidolls Cafe. And I'm bringing this conversation. Actually, there's some parts of the conversation that are important, no? And I'm bringing this back to bring back memories, especially that I will be reaching my 10th year being active in the anime cosplay community since 2009. So with that said, I'll be bringing you my conversation, my discussion with Rhea Ayunan. She is the head, the dancho, how am I supposed to say it? The one behind Meidolls Cafe. She's the owner of it. So with that said, let's get to the recording.
Keepsakes, the podcast.
So okay, I'm here with may I know your identities, please?
I'm Meidoll Rhea.
And I'm Meidoll Nyanyan.
Nyanyan. So may iba pa tayo mga kasama dito na maids?
Right now we only have two for Shiprag mornings.
Then at the evenings?
Usually three, pero depende rin sa volume. Minsan nag-full staff kami.
So, pakilala nyo naman sa amin yung mga ibang mga maids na, ano, what's your opportunity?
Yeah, we have Meidoll Yu, na isa sa mga kilalang cosplayers, o ano.
Should we say Yu Shamura?
Yu Shamura, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, and she was, ano, diba, featured sa Matanglawin last Sunday. And then we also have, Meidoll Ayan is also a popular cosplayer then. And she won an award, diba, yung Tekken.
So you're a Tekken cosplayer?
Yes.
Okay.
Not all the time, pero I just bagged the 2010 Tekken cosplayer award for best female.
Okay.
Then, and we also have Meidoll Sara, na isa din cosplayer. Meidoll Tami, cosplayer din siya. And Meidoll Kriza. Magiging cosplayer pa lang. Udyong ka na.
So, this staff is major...
Sorry, Meidoll Sai pa pala. Meron pa kami. We have one more Meidoll Sai who is a chef. Culinary graduate. So, rest assured na most of our products ay Meidoll-made talaga. So, gawa talaga namin.
So, how did you start the concept of this maid cafe?
Well, 3 years ago, I had this... Actually, I just finished watching Coffee Prince 3 years ago. And I had this idea na parang, oh, I want to have a coffee shop as well kasi coffee lover ako. Tapos, biglang sabi ko, wala pa nga palang maid cafe, kasi otaku na ako ever since. So, wala pa palang maid cafe dito sa Philippines. I think it would be nice if somebody will start this kind of business dito sa bansa natin. Kasi sa ibang Asian countries meron na, even sa US. So, yun, I went abroad. Nag-ipon ako ng account ng ano, ng pangkapital, and then when I finally got what, you know, yung amount na kailangan ko, I went back here, and then yung conceptualization ng whole business took 3 months. It started October, but then I started moving mga November, so basically November, December yung lahat ng processing ng designs and all the menus, staffing, gano'n.
So, matagal pa lang pagpa-planner to?
Yeah, matagal ko nang kinonceptualize, pinangarap, yeah. Pero yung pinaka-conceptualization nung ano, nung buong cafe, like yung designs and stuff, just took 3 to 2 weeks. Months.
2 to 3 months.
Two to three months. So you serve here. I have the menu. So we have coffee, frappe, pastries, deli, pasta, rice, specialties, etc. Should I say?
Yeah.
So medyo nagtataka ako kung bakit dito mismo sa Saunterfield Building sa Cainta, dito na napagpasyang tumayo.
Well, dahil lang sa sobrang kagustuhan kong ma-push through itong business and magkaroon ng maid cafe dito sa Philippines.
Right away.
Talagang inano na namin. Kasi ito na yung pinakamurang rent. If mag-renta ako sa mall, it will be like 40,000 per month. And then we tried din sa harapan, sa Rublu, which is a good location sana, but then malaki pa ang gagastusin. Yeah, if I'm gonna wait for that time na magkaroon ako ng just about the right amount na para lang mabuksan yung cafe, it might take years again. And but you know, I really want to materialize this. And like, start small lang muna. Yun yung parang naisip ko. Start small. Kahit na medyo hindi kita yung lugar, umaasa na lang siguro kami sa word of mouth. Kasi we assure naman best quality yung product namin. At saka masarap. So, mag word of mouth and proper marketing and advertising.
When I found out that my friend Ivan just entered the place in its grand opening. Actually, nakapunan t-shirt siya eh. I saw it on his Facebook, then right away. Okay, promotion. Okay, so she will be back. So siya yung, Meidolls Cafe yung...
Yes, she's her boss. We're her
Meidolls. The head honcho, should we say. I'm looking at the menu.
The ones with the Hello Kitty stickers are temporarily not available.
Temporarily not available.
But it will be.
It will be maybe next month or so?
Next week. In the next week. Depende sa flow ng customers. Of course, as we said, we're starting small. So, depende din sa flow ng people. We'll be adding more since we mentioned we have a chef in our staff.
I see.
By the way, did you like the experience, Ivan? You told me you went here and...
Yes, definitely. Medyo natatakam ako na pumunta dito to taste the food which you served. But as of now, keep it. I'm in a Thai credit policy. So sa grand opening ninyo, yung grand opening ninyo, a full blast naman.
Oh yeah, we were very jam-packed here nung grand opening. We're happy kasi daming pumunta to support and to congratulate us.
Even I think that includes otakultura.com, right?
Yeah.
Otakultura.com.
Actually, we had two openings, one for the press and one for the grand opening for everyone. We had one for the press. We invited the not all came. Yung mga otaku groups, mga like Pao.
Philippine Anime Otakus.
Yeah. We also had TNPH. We also had Anime Alliance. We also invited Cosplay that page, but unfortunately, baka hindi sila available that time. Kasi medyo short notice.
Mm-hmm. So medyo nakita rin. Puro pink talaga dito. So
yes, our theme is honeysuckle pink, black, and white.
Honeysuckle pink, black, and white.
We just had water.
Okay.
So,
ano pang
like
may...
ambience?
Ah, ambience. Pero, ganito talaga siya. Open window talaga siya.
As of today, kasi we want the people to, because of course it's new, and some non-otaku customers might be curious what this place is about. So we left it open muna for them to see what's happening inside. So for now, yes. Open muna.
Okay, that's okay. So, how did you get... Okay, so we will talk to Meidoll, right? Right. Baka mamaya magkamali naman ako. Panginoon ko. Okay, so how did... So, nakuha mo yung mga cosplayers as staff. How did you get them?
Ah, great story. Iba't ibang paraan. Sige, simulan natin si Aryan. Si Aryan yung pinakauna ko kasi nakita. Paano nga ba? Somebody...
Your blurt.
Yeah, kasi nag-post ako sa blurt. Sa Twitter, sa Facebook, and then somebody found my work interesting kasi nga first maid cafe. And then ni-replert niya, nakita ni Aryan, nag-submit.
Oh, actually, hindi ko nakita. My close friend saw it. And she wants to apply kasi unfortunately, she's from Paranaque and she's still a high school student. So, having a job is a no-no for her for now. So, she said, Ate Aryan, please apply, please continue my dream. Tapos I was like, oh my god, it's so cute naman, maid cafe. Sige, mag-apply ako as part-time kasi may job ako eh. So, I applied din.
Tapos yung iba naman, nakita lang din nila sa referrals, just like Aryan, Pulse referrals, nabanggit sa kanila na may maid cafe, and then nagtatanong sila paano mag-apply. Some of them naman, nag-message sa akin sa Facebook. So, sinasabi ko sa kanila yung way of applying. And then, there were some groups who supported me by reposting my ad sa kanilang website. So, yung mga otaku sa nakita, they submitted their resumes and pictures kasi meron din siyang screening. So, after viewing nung resumes nila, sinecheck ko, of course, yung kanilang... Let's say na what I'm looking for here is not only yung yung magandang attitude and yung may experience, but also we're looking for the person with the X factor. Kasi we want the Meidolls Cafe to be known na maid cafe, just like in Japan, hindi yung maid cafe kasi mukhang, no offense. Pero, yun nga, so ini-screen namin sila, first, and then we schedule a screening then yung personal screening, yung titignan ko yung mga applicants. Oh, and then there's the interview, and then after that konting audition, and then that's when we choose yung final pick. So yeah, actually there's about 30 applicants na nag-inquire and nag-submit. But out of those 30, sila lang, si itong 6 yung natanggap.
May babanggitin ako ng mga pangalan. Magugulat kayo. So, please tell me kung anong naisip nyo sa mga groups, organizations, names, etc. that will come from my mouth. So, okay, let's start. Okay, cosplay.ph.
Oh, yeah. They're good people naman. They support us too.
AAP?
Oh, yeah. Very supportive.
So, anime conventions.
Fun. We're planning to hold exhibits there every time. Actually, meron na kaming couple of conventions na invited.
Every opportunity that we can, it's also a way to like promote the cafe. So every opportunity, every offer that we get from convention, siguro will accept it.
Internet?
Helpful, but also scary. Like, kasi yung mga taong pipira sa... I'll stop talking about it. But yeah, it's very helpful kasi through internet kami nag-promote. through internet din kami nakilala. Apart from word of mouth. But then again, yung word of mouth came later after I started advertising through the internet. So it's very helpful. And also we have up na po sa internet yung www.maidollscafe.com. So nilalagyan na lang po namin ng content and it's ready to go.
So maidollscafe.com, we'll check out that soon, but for now your site is
maidollscafe.multiply.com and also from Facebook Maidolls Cafe fan page.
How about cosplay? The cosplay itself in general, ano masasabi niyo?
Well, actually, before I came here, up to now, I'm an active cosplayer. I cosplay every available convention, every time I'm available. So, it's like a very dear hobby to me.
So, anime?
Fun. I like it. I love it. They're cute. They're kawaii. I like the stories. I like the drawings, the art.
Kawaii, that's nice. Okay, so, favorite anime?
I can't name them.
Oh, madami eh. Pero yung pinaka talaga, from the, in which started my interest in the Japanese culture is Ghost Fighter. Tsaka Ranma 1/2.
Yu Yu Hakusho and Ranma 1/2. Okay. Hulaan ko, napalood niya lang yan sa GMA.
Yeah.
I visited 13, yung Ghost Fighter, ano pa, nung time kasi na introduce ako sa Ghost Fighter, hindi pa siya mainstream. Nasa Channel 9 pa lang yata siya, or Channel 13. Yung hindi pa siya yung big time channel. Ano pa lang siya, yung kukunting mga tao pa lang yung nanonood. So, yun. Ganun na ako. Ganun ako katagal nahilig sa anime. I think late 6.
Okay, mga panahon pa yun ng after, post-martial years.
Post-anime convention years. Wala pa mga cosplay.
Wala pa mga cosplay, so there was an anime convention.
Wala pa mga anime conventions na nahilig ako sa anime. Kaya, nung nahilig ako sa anime, wala pang nakakaalam masyado sa anime. So, very few people pa lang, hindi pa siya mainstream. Tapos, wala pang conventions. There's no such thing as cosplay pa sa Philippines. And then kami, wala pang mga comic alley. So, kapag kami gusto namin ng mga anime, parang VHS pa siya, na parang, naman ako kaya, galing Japan, bayram. Tapos yung mga manga, pinagdadamot pa, parang hanggang sa mag-drool na lang kami sa mga, tapos kukunti lang talaga kami. Tapos every time na magkaroon kami ng kopya, na for example, yung Ghost Fighter, nung nagkaroon pa na sa VHS pa siya, pinag-aagawan namin, isang linggo sa akin, isang araw lang sa'yo, kasi ganyan. So, yun.
Okay, speaking of which, manga.
Manga, unang manga na nabasa ko, Sailor Moon. Tapos ano pa yun, sabi nung kaibigan ko, imported pa daw yun sa Japan. Kasi nga wala pa nga kasi mga suppliers pa dito nun. So talagang agawan pa kami nun. Buti ko siya meron siya. Tapos yun pa yung panahon ng mga text. Yung parang may, nung medyo sumikat na yung nung sumisikat na yung Ghost Fighter, biglang sa mga bawat sari-sari store, nagbebenta na ng mga text. That's the nearest that's the nearest thing na nagkaroon ako sa isang anime shop. Ngayon, meron ng mga plushies, mga posters. That time, text lang kami. Yung mga text cards.
Okay. Favorite, nasabi na ni Meidori yung favorite manga. How about you? You have experienced manga?
Of course, I read manga as for reference for my concerts. Pero hindi kasi ako super manga fan because I'm too lazy to read. I prefer watching animes over manga. Sorry. Pero kasi yung pagka-otaku ko is more on games and anime.
Okay, the word itself, otaku, ano masasabi niyo?
The word itself? Otaku. Well, it's a too deep of a word to describe it for me.
When you say otaku, it means sobrang fan siya ng something. right? Na Japanese culture related. So, I guess being ano ta ako means being addicted to something na cute and kawaii na naman. Something interesting. Kasi let's face it, Japanese culture is a very interesting culture talaga. So, yeah.
Okay, speaking of which, you have talked about the specialty stores. Anong masasabi niya sa Siya Central?
He's been supporting our cafe actually, promoting it with us. And Siya Central, well, it's also an establishment. Why should he comment? He's also doing his business.
So the same as Turats and Comic Alley.
Yes.
So speaking of which, we have the Japanese pop culture. And how about the Korean pop culture?
Sorry, we're actually going to be an exhibitor sa, yeah, look, we're watching Korean drama right now. But yeah, come February 13, we'll be one of the food exhibitors sa K-pop, sa Dream Story, sa K-pop convention. So, yeah, ayun namin mag-discriminate. K-pop culture fans and J-culture otakus are welcome to come here. Even regular people na hindi mahilig sa anime but are also welcome to come here. So, yeah, K-pop culture, we like it. We love it. We even watch it. We even listen to Suju. Minsan nagpa-play kami na Suju, Boa, Tiara.
So, Meidolls Cafe in general is not just a cafe pertaining to Japanese pop culture, but the Korean pop culture itself.
Yes.
So I saw your videos. Dito mismo kayo nag-perform nung...
Yes, that's a mini stage.
Yeah. And please can you tell me? Of course, I know that the how can I say it? Tatami mat. How the dining area in the Japanese in a Japanese house looks like this. But can you explain to us why the chairs have no legs?
Actually, in design nitong chairs and tables, we took it from a Japanese home na design. So we really searched talaga.
Korean style like this too. So hindi lang siya Japanese and hindi lang siya Japanese inspired. So it's a mixture of both arts.
Saka iniisip ko namin if ano lang cushion lang, paano yung mga gusto ng sumandal, di ba? Also, if you search Google and then you type low table, ang kapartner talaga ng low table sa Japan and Korea are chairs na ganito. Yung walang paa. Some also prefer cushions. So we are also providing cushions dun sa mga ayaw ng may sandalan. So,
okay, the design... Okay, medyo nakikita ko na ngayon ang magiging, how can I say it, magiging kalabasan itong designs, the menu, the maids, of course. So, I can safely say na this is really the first maid cafe in the Philippines.
I hope it will become more successful. Kasi, the more na magkaroon kami ng maraming customers, the more na maraming maido akong pwedeng ipag-ship sa isang ship. Kasi like now, since hindi pa, we're just beginning, so dalawa lang muna per ship. So, but then, we are aware na people are expecting, when you say maid cafe, they are expecting, lots of maids. Pero the thing is, if you keep supporting us, we'll provide you with more meat.
And also, better location in the future is this.
So if you keep supporting us, we'll improve. Rest assured na hindi kami magsistop na hanggang dito lang. We'll improve every time na magkaroon ng progress.
Location, food, staff, everything will be improved.
Okay, so since I got here, excuse me, of course, you don't know the DOH. So I was a partner in their Otaku's Verdict 2010. And
what does the COH stand for?
Then the Zen Otaku Honbu.
Okay.
So itanong niyo rin sa mga other maidos. So the most popular na yung talaga major anime event, major anime con of the 2010 is the, okay, should I say a major, minor event of 2010 is the Ozin Otaku Expo 2010.
Major naman siya.
Major siya. So, okay. Ganyan talaga pag busy ang mga professionals. So, may motivation. So, since ng Otaku Expo 2010, the first OtaX features the veteran cosplayer Alodia. And, of course, I admit, I had a picture of her. So we were in the Ozin Maid Cafe. So my question is, kung yung mga maid cafe dun sa cons, pumapatok siya, are there any chances na pumatok kayo dito?
We already tried one convention, Christmas Toy Fair 2010. And well, hindi naman na bakante yung booth namin that time, so it's a success for me.
Yeah, 3 days po siya, and during those 3 days, naging super busy kami, like, yung sila, full staff talaga kami nung ano, and we also have volunteers, and even na marami kami volunteers, even na kompleto kami nun, sobrang busy pa rin lahat. Sobrang lahat kami hindi nabakante sa trabaho kasi dating na dating yung customers. Kasi we're not only, yung sinaserve namin during the convention is not limited to just one kind of product. We were serving coffee, hot drinks, we were serving cold drinks.
We're serving real food. Hindi lang kasi kami service group. Kasi yung other groups, I am aware of some other maid groups. They are service group. We are a food providing group.
And like I said, most of our products kami mismo gumawa. So, meron akong confidence sa ano namin, sa products namin.
Okay, another word from yours truly, Anani Bear, Pandasal, Otakultura.
Otakultura, yeah, we heard of them. Actually, they were able to interview us last J Crunch. Yeah, they were there and then they interviewed us and they in fact posted yung interview namin sa kanilang site. So yeah, they're very helpful naman, supporting them.
Okay. Of course, regular naman na may customers dito in this first 3 days of the Meidolls Cafe.
I don't know about now kasi magsisimula pa lang yung araw namin. But yesterday,
weekend naman, ay naman yung business nung opening, it was full, jam-packed.
Jam-packed.
But Sunday, it was okay in the afternoon, in the evening. So, we're expecting naman na medyo walang tao pag weekdays because everybody's working, everybody's going to school. So, we're expecting just weekdays for more customers.
Okay, so may possibility ba na pumatok ang cosplay dito sa Rizal?
We're hoping. Why not? I mean, there are many youth here. Possibly, mahilig din sa... Actually, there was one year na nakapag-aral. Kasi lumaki ako sa Riyadh. Pero there was one year nakapag-aral ako dito sa Philippines. And dito ako sa Cainta nag-aral. Sa Greenland Academy. Greenland Academy yung foundation ng aking anime, nagiging addict sa anime kasi yung mga tropa ko sa Greenland Academy, sila yung nag-introduce sa akin sa Ghost Fighter. And ever since, na-hook na ako and may diretso na. So in a way, thankful ako dito sa Cainta talaga. Kaya ibang reason din kung ba't dito ko siya hinanap. Kasi dito nagsimula yung interest ko sa J-culture. If it weren't for that interest, hindi naman mabubuksan. Hindi ko to mabubuksan itong Meidolls Cafe.
Okay, so, of course, okay, so, because of the episode of Matang Lawin last Sunday, January 16, sad, hindi ko napanood yun. So, parang yun na yung magiging, yun na ba yung magiging start ng pagiging mainstream ng cosplay dito sa Pilipinas?
Well, actually, matagal na siya. Kaya nga, nagkaroon ng ng cosplayer sa Matang Lawin because it's already been, I mean, it's already been mainstream a couple of months ago pa.
But even years ago, kasi through Hero TV, di ba? I mean, Hero TV is
cosplayers even before pa.
I would say mainstream na siya.
Well, for ordinary people to know cosplay, maybe I think it started, I mean, your ordinary people started knowing the cosplay community, or maybe even the word cosplay started 2010, I think.
And yeah, let's face it, hindi lang sa Matang Lawin, but we have nothing against sa pagiging celebrity ni Aloja. In fact, what I think is dahil sa kanyang pagiging celebrity, mainstream celebrity na, mas na-introduce yung cosplay sa mga tao. So, yeah. So, at least hindi na sila parang may isip, ay, weirdo naman ang mga nakakostume na yan. At least mag-open na sila. Mm-hmm. Magiging open.
So, okay. Cosplay in Japan. Cosplay in Japan itself.
Very grabe. Wala akong masasabi kasi talaga artistic sila eh. Meron pa nga silang, di ba, parang isang district na puro cosplay every Friday ba or something?
No, even regular days.
I think it's part of their living eh. Their way of life.
If cosplaying were a job, would you accept it?
Kaya nun. This is us.
It's actually,
I'm already doing that.
Now, actually, we're in maid cafe costumes. It's like cosplaying every day. Itong costume namin. Kasi usually, we just wear these kapag we're wearing this kind of costume every time lang may convention lang, eh, di ba?
Or a shoot. Oh. And also, we also have days like cosplay days here. We also have seifuku days. We even have cross-dress days here.
Kahapon was cosplay day, so we were in cosplay. Our Meidolls na naka-shift kahapon, Meidolls Sarah, me, and we invited one more cosplayer na naka-cosplay kami lang.
So, okay. So, we'll talk about cosplay later. Okay. So, have you heard of the Winter 2011 anime season?
No.
No?
Hmm?
No. Winter 2011 anime season.
Updated, we don't know that.
Sorry, we were busy planning this.
Busy talaga kami with Meidolls. Like I said, we don't have time na makikika-chika or, you know, update sa mga ibang bagay. Kasi, like I said, we're more focused on our professional work sa Meid Cafe. Sorry, we haven't heard of it yet.
Okay. Facepalm to me. Okay, haters.
We may iwasan. You know, we can't
haven't heard any yet. They were just some trying to, like, open a topic about hating us. I have read one opening, like, let's talk about Meidolls, but nobody replied. So I was like, okay, safe pa. So as long as we're doing our job, wala pa kaming nalalaso na tao, or wala pa kaming like coffee na ginawang salt tasting coffee. Diba? That's still fulfillment for me as long as we're doing our jobs right.
Okay. Bago magsimula tong Meid Cafe business, balikan natin yung mga nakaraan na how did you start cosplaying?
Ayan, no.
Rather, she's been in there since hindi pa mainstream of cosplay. Tell her. Hey, tell him.
Year 2002 yata or 2003, nagko-cosplay na ako. That time pa nagsisimula pa lang. If you're familiar of you, or if you've heard of Diane Lopez. Hindi na siya ano. Nantanong ka pa na ako ng kisapot. I'm not an active cosplayer now. But
you years before. Your pictures before. She's with Alodia. The Alodia before.
Di ba si Alodia G? She's been cosplaying ever since 2003. Kasabay ko siyang mag-start. Yung isa sa mga una niyang cosplay, na andun din ako cosplaying.
Well, if you will tell veteran cosplayers, Minimo ni PH, they will know right away who Rhea is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pero sobrang tagal. Ayun. So matagal na akong cosplayer. It's just that I stopped after nga na nag-focus ako sa... Well, aminin na natin din. Actually, aminin na natin na may mga issues sa cosplay community na may mga naninira. And so minsan nakaka-dishearten kasi You're cosplaying dahil gusto mo. Let's just say, din ngayon, long story. Sige, isa-isay natin. Noong time kasi na nagko-cosplay kami before, it was all for fun. It was all for, you know, make-believe na parang for a day, ikaw yung paborito mong character. For example, ako si Yuna. Pag nagsuot ako ng cosplay, feeling ko ako si Yuna. For that day. And I make, parang nasa fantasy world ako. So, yun lang yun eh. Yung sayang nafe-feel mo pag naka-costume ka. Wearing your favorite cosplayers. Anime sa costume. But lately, when I went back here, after ko nang magtrabaho sa Riyadh, nakita ko, ang daming magagaling ng cosplayers, nag-improve talaga yung quality. And everybody's wearing wig na para mas perfect yung cosplay. But, I'm just disappointed din sa mga ibang tao na they're cosplaying for attention. Cosplaying is not para makilala ka, maging popular ka, maging artista ka. Cosplaying is, is a hobby na para ma-feel mo na, saka mailabas mo yung creativity mo. Kasi most cosplayers, sila gumagawa mismo ng costume, nagtatahi like Aryan. So, they're releasing not only yung interest nila, but also their creative juices. But lately, may mga cosplayers na parang, let's cosplay kasi maraming picture sa atin para tayo celebrity. So, yun lang yung disappointing thing ngayon compared dun sa dating panahon na cosplay na kahit na hindi pulido, at least yung passion talaga nandun. And ito na yung isang medal namin, si Kiza.
About that, yun ang nakakatakot. Yun ang nakakatakot. Pag naging mainstream ang cosplay, okay, so, hello. Okay, so, pakilala niyo sa amin.
That's Meidolls Cafe. Yeah, Meidolls Cafe. And hindi pa siya naka-BS, so magta-transform na siya maya-maya.
Hindi siya siya. Okay. So, back to the topic. Yun na nakakatakot pag naging mainstream ang cosplay. Paano kaya kung pag talagang cosplay naging super mainstream na yun talagang kinukuhanan ng mga people, mga press people, media people, na maging models? And artist.
Nasa sa kanila na yun kasi kanya-kanyang hilig lang talaga yan, kanya-kanyang passion. If you believe what you really want, if you want to do what you really want, do it. Wala kang pipigil sa'yo kahit maging cosplayer pa si Manong Card over there. Kapag gusto mo yung ginagawa mo and you want to express yourself well, you will do what you're supposed to do.
Pero yun na, yung sinabi mo, well, like we mentioned a while ago, matagal nang naging mainstream ang cosplay. Kaya nga nagkaroon ng mga attention getter na cosplay kuno. Cosplayer kuno pala. Dahil they found it, we're getting attention. So, let's cosplay na. Interesting yung mga cosplayers, they get to be a celebrity for a day. Sige, we want that too. In fact, meron nga isang umamin sa amin. Na kaya lang siya nagko-cosplay once a year. Sometimes, usually once a year daw, para lang magpapansin. So, parang when we heard them, like, kasi kami, actually, I have to be frank with you, mostly nang tinanggap ko is mga passionate cosplayers. Aryan, you, Sarah. Kung mapapansin mo rin yung mga cosplay nila, parang, pulido, ang galing talaga. So no, when we heard that from that person, we're like,
Godes.
Okay. Well, as
I said, we're not going to pigil it. Gagawin namin what we're supposed to do if we really like what we're doing. Actually, well, matagal na yan mga attention seekers na yan. Let's say, I don't have anything against them as long as I am doing what I want. Well, sometimes, nakaka-discourage din na to be surrounded with people na they're getting more appreciation than yung hours of job na ginawa mo sa costume.
Dahil maganda lang. Ay, sorry.
Okay, that's okay. Okay.
Pero as long as you like what you're doing, you believe that you're more capable of what they're doing.
Sa akin kasi cosplay is all about art and passion. And it's just disappointing na other cosplayers are napapansin. Instead of yung mga talagang dapat mapansin, like let's say yung mga Masked Rider cosplayers. I mean, tingnan mo yung details ng kanilang costume. They really worked hard for those. And talagang may kita mo pulido. And naka sila maskara, so hindi mo makikilala kung sino sila. So that really means na nagko-cosplay sila dahil passion nila at gusto nilang ilabas yung creative uses nila. Sila ang dapat mapansin. Sila yung dapat ma-feature. But instead, mostly nang na-feature are mga... Sorry, I have to be frank as well. Ang mga napapansin is yung mga kinukosplay, mga cosplayers na porket maganda at sexy. Na-feature na nila. Bakit? Nag-cosplay ba sila? Yun yung tanong. Nag-cosplay sila, nang pulido ba yung kanilang... Baka naman nag-cosplay lang sila a couple of times in a sexy outfit, tapos biglang, na sila, cosplayer na sila, tapos signature na sila dahil maganda sila. Yun yung disappointing part sa cosplaying ngayon. Yung mga dapat na mapansin talagang cosplayer na nag-work hard, hindi sila yung napapansin. Yung mga talagang cosplayer, hindi napapansin. Yun lang.
One time na, of course, between these, kasi halos isang taon na rin ako na nasa anime fan base which I want to call it kasi parang ang otaku sa akin is a derogatory word na anime fan base na mga nakilala ko na rin, may mga veteran, may mga friends ako na sa forums, especially Ivan on the Hero TV forums when I was there, then of course the VOH and others. Then this ToyCon 2011, will you be there?
Yeah, we are. Actually, doon pa lang Toy Fair, Christmas Toy Fair, kinausap na ako ni Sir Vic na we should, na nireserbahan na niya kami ng pwesto as an exhibitor. I don't know, kasi parang nag-hint na sila sa amin na they're planning something big for us daw. So hopefully, parang maging ASA Maid Cafe yung gawin nila para sa amin, para masaya.
Of course, nalaman nyo naman ng Anime Festival Asia. Do yourself Anime Festival Asia, right? Sa Singapore.
Kasi kilala ko siya sa ASA. Yeah.
Of course, you know Danny Chu.
Yeah.
Of course. You have a Professor Figure FM.
No. Okay. Figure FM?
Figure FM.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. So, magkakasundo tayo yan. I was blogging about cosplay in mainstream media.
Okay,
medyo maganda din ang Coffee Prince, ha? So, dyan ka na-inspire. sa mga susunod na conventions, so we have the February convention, Osin Fest 2010. Osin Fest.
Ay, nako.
Not sure because Osin, of course, they will have Osin.
They have their own meet cafe na kasi. No. The other conventions na walang maid cafe, kami yung ini-invite. For example, yung Cosmania X. Yes.
Cosmania X. You have been in Cosmania X.
No, we are invited na. before 2011.
Yeah, of course, the proposal yun.
2010, wala pa yung cafe namin.
Keepsakes, the podcast.
And that's for the Meidolls Cafe, you know. Nowadays, you won't be able to see Meidolls Cafe. They're permanently closed. But the legacy lives on, and it's still there. It's the stories featured on Thomson Reuters. It's still there. And on YouTube, it's still there. You can still see it. And very, very important yung mga happenings na nangyari dyan, ano. Following Meidolls Cafe was the Talking Apples Cafe, and then following that, I'm not sure kung ano yung sumunod eh. I believe it's themed cafes. So mga pang-seasonal to. Hindi ito yung parang you can visit Monday to Friday. You can just visit it on a specific date where organizers reserve a day in specific cafes around the metro to hold the cafe, and this, after all, still gets visitors. Those who want to eat, those who want to chat and hang out with their characters. Of course, the future of it is themed cafes, pero hindi siya yung seasonal. I have yet to know a cafe similar to that in Manila, but in Cebu, there's a cafe. I believe if you've heard our discussion with Gary Montejo a few episodes back, nabanggit niya yung pangalan. I just forgot it eh. So yeah, that will be it. And speaking of Cebu, see you at Otaku Fest. They again, as of this recording, we're still in need of the info for the location. Hopefully, ma-sort out na ni Otaku Fest, because I'm already signing up as a partner there, a media partner. So like with my visit to the NIC in Davao, I'll be telling the story of Otaku Fest to the people in Manila, to the people in Davao, and I'll take this opportunity na rin, ano, to really, really, really experience the cosplay community in Cebu City, the one that I was not able to experience on my first trip way back 2016. That's the end of the year. So I'll be seeing you there. Following that, I did mention that I already got my ticket to Cosplay Carnival, and looking forward to see you there. Also, Ozin Fest 2019. Also, ToyCon 2019. So, yeah. See you at these events. That wraps up another episode of Keepsakes, the podcast. New episodes can be heard on anchor.fm/keepsakes, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and Spotify. You can follow me on Twitter at @jagonoy. More updates will be posted on facebook.com/keepsakesbyjay. Leave your voice messages using the Anchor app, available on Google Play and the App Store. Shout out to Lee Rosebear for the music. Thank you for listening to the podcast, and I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time.